Hey everyone, welcome back to Science in Real Life. I'm Molly and I'm here with Matt.
Hey guys.
And he is a PhD student in the Department of Biology, and he's here because this episode is all about mitosis, and Matt studies mitosis as part of his graduate research.
We're going to have a quick review of mitosis, and this is the process by which somatic cells divide. And somatic's just a fancy word for all the cells in your body, apart from your eggs and your sperm, and those divide by meiosis.
If your biology teacher is as awesome as mine was, you'll never get the two confused, because mitosis in my toes, meiosis in my ovaries. Unless you're a man, in which case, good luck remembering. The DNA in a cell's nucleus is always highly organized, and this makes sense, right? If you want to express certain genes, you have to know they are. And one level of this organization is called chromatin, and the DNA is tightly wound up around some proteins which then wind some more and form a nice little ribbon of chromatin.
At the beginning of mitosis, the chromatin ribbons will condense down to form separate structures known as chromosomes. And so these chromosomes will then line up along the middle of your nucleus, and then they separate away into the two distinct cells that are formed during mitosis. And this means the two cells produced will have an equal amount of DNA. Normally that works fine. Occasionally it goes wrong, and so you might end up with an extra chromosome or one too few. When this happens, most of the time the cell dies because it's not good. Occasionally the cell can do better off and grow quicker. This is what leads to cancer often. What I study is how the segregation of the chromosomes happens and is regulated, and how the cell makes sure it's always correct.
Today we'll be looking at the chromosomes of yeast cells undergoing mitosis, and Matt studies a protein complex that helps all of this go smoothly.
The protein complex I study is called condensin, and so the way condensin works is it helps you go from the messy nucleus full of chromosomes that you normally have, and it helps it tightly package down into the chromosomes that can be easily separated during mitosis. And so the analogy often used for this is, you imagine you have all this crazy hair, and then it acts as a hair clip. Tidy it all up. So we're going to start off by taking some of the yeast that's been growing on this plate. We're going to scrape a little bit off, and we're going to put it into some nice liquid food for it to grow in.
And now we're going into this warm room so that the yeast can be happy and warm while it's growing. And now it has to incubate overnight. And now it's ready.
In this tube, we have our yeast cells, which have been growing mitotically overnight. And so they're all happy and they've been dividing lots. I'm gonna put some of them in this tube. The next step is we add formaldehyde. What formaldehyde does is essentially freezes the cells in time and space.
Stop time, tell your friends.
This means it's gonna keep all the proteins and DNA fixed together.
And now it's time to digest the cell walls of the yeast. So I'm going to add a mixture of enzymes and add it to that pellet of yeast cells. And this gets rid of the cell walls of the yeast because we wanna see what's inside the cell. And then I put them on the rotator for a while to make sure that the digestion is complete.
So now we're going to take these cells and put them onto our microscope slide. So this slide has lots of little wells in it. This means the cells will sink to the bottom, they'll stick to the glass, and so in the next steps they won't wash away. So now the cells have settled to the bottom of the well, we can just vacuum off the remaining liquid. The next step is adding antibody.
So you might be familiar already with antibodies' roles in our own immune systems. They tag infectious agents so the immune system can target them for destruction. But it turns out that scientists can use antibodies in the lab for our own purposes. This antibody is tagging tubulin, and we can look at the tubulin on a microscope.
Tubulin is really important because it's a protein that's part of the skeleton of the cell that helps provide the structure that pulls the cells apart.
And DAPI is a dye that will bind to the DNA, and when we look at it under a microscope, it'll show up as bright blue.
So now our cells are all ready, so we just add a cover slip to the slide, and this protects the cells while they're on the microscope.
So as you can see, we have dividing cells here, and labeled in blue is the DNA, and you can see the two circles have separated away from each other, and so this means that mitosis is working nicely.
And you can also see it labeled in green is our tubulin, which we labeled the antibody. You can see the nice line of tubulin as it starts to pull the DNA apart, and then it breaks down as the DNA is separate.
We also made some mutant cells.
Now they can finally join the X-Men. Stan Lee, have your people call my people.
Not quite. These guys are mutant for the condensing complex. As you can see, the DNA isn't doing so well. It's trying to separate, but it's not working. This means they're probably gonna die.
So Matt, how will you use these experiments in your research?
So as you can see, the condensin complex is really important for mitosis. And using experiments such as these, I can start to understand what it's normally doing, and then take it one step further and understand what goes wrong in events such as cancer.
Well, thanks so much for being here and doing the experiment with us, and thank you for watching Science in Real Life. We'll see you next time.